Σήμερα είναι μια πολύ σημαντική μέρα για την πραγματική οικονομία. Είναι μια σημαντική μέρα ειδικά για τις μικρομεσαίες επιχειρήσεις. Υποδεχόμαστε τον αντιπρόεδρο της Ευρωπαϊκής Τράπεζας Επενδύσεων, παλιό γνωστό, καλό φίλο της Ελλάδος, τον κύριο Άντριου Μακτάουλ. Και μαζί προχωρούμε σε μια πολύ σημαντική κίνηση για τις μικρές, τις μεσαίες επιχειρήσεις της χώρας. Ένα νέο ταμείο, το οποίο θα ενισχύσει με περίπου μισό δισεκατομμύριο ευρώ τις τράπεζες, ώστε και αυτές με τη σειρά τους να τα διαθέσουν αμέσως σε νέα αναπτυξιακά σχέδια. Και αυτό σημαίνει ότι σε 90 μέρες από αύριο τα πιστωτικά ιδρύματα θα μπορούν να δανειοδοτούν εταιρείες και νέες επενδύσεις ουσιαστικά χωρίς ρίσκο, γιατί αυτό πλέον θα το εγγυάται η Ευρωπαϊκή Τράπεζα. Έτσι, σημαντική νέα ρευστότητα μπαίνει στην αγορά. Οι επιχειρήσεις που αναζητούσαν χρηματοδότηση και έβρισκαν συχνά κλειστές πόρτες λόγω των υψηλών εγγύησεων που ζητούσαν οι τράπεζες, τώρα θα τη βρίσκουν. Και έτσι, νέα επιχειρηματικά σχέδια θα μπορούν να ξεκινούν γρήγορα, φέρνοντας νέες θέσεις εργασίας. Κεντρικό ρόλο εδώ αναλαμβάνει το Ταμείο Εγκυοδοσίας, την ίδρυση του οποίου συνυπογράφουμε. Και αξίζει να επισημανθούν όμως και δύο ακόμα στοιχεία που συνδέουν τη συγκεκριμένη πρωτοβουλία με την επικαιρότητα. Αυτή η πρωτοβουλία εκδηλώνεται σε μία στιγμή ερωτημάτων για την πορεία της διεθνούς οικονομίας και κατά συνέπεια και της ελληνικής οικονομίας λόγω του κορονοϊού. Και τώρα είναι η ώρα να στηριχθεί ακόμα περισσότερο η πραγματική οικονομία και τις αμέσως επόμενες μέρες θα γίνουν ανακοινώσεις για τα πολύ συγκεκριμένα μέτρα τα οποία θα λάβει η ελληνική κυβέρνηση προκειμένου να ανακουφίσει αυτούς οι οποίοι πλήττονται οικονομικά από την εξάπλωση του ιού. Η δεύτερη συγκυρία που έχει ένα ενδιαφέρον αφορά την δεδομένη πρόθεση της Ευρωπαϊκής Τράπεζας Επενδύσεων να στηρίξει τη χώρα μας για την αντιμετώπιση του προσφυγικού μεταναστευτικού προβλήματος. Και θέλω να εκφράσω την ικανοποίησή μου, γιατί ήδη υπάρχει ένας διάβλος επικοινωνίας μεταξύ της Τράπεζας και του αρμόδιου υπουργού του κ. Μηταράκη και αναμένουμε και την έμπρακτη στήριξη με χρηματοδοτικά εργαλεία αυτής της μεγάλης προσπάθειας, αυτού του μεγάλου βάρους που έχει αναλάβει η χώρα μας. Το Ευρωπαϊκό Ταμείο Επενδύσεων είναι βέβαια παλιός γνώριμος των ελληνικών μικρομεσαίων επιχειρήσεων. Τη στηρίζει με πολλά χρηματοδοτικά εργαλεία. Το Jeremy Holding Fund χορήγησε δάνεια σε παραπάνω από 3.000 επιχειρήσεις. Πρωτοβουλία Equifund χρηματοδοτεί συμμετοχές στην ανάπτυξη νεοφυών επιχειρήσεων. Κλείνω εκφράζοντας την ικανοποίησή μου για αυτήν την εξέλιξη. It's a great pleasure to have you here today. I think what we're doing is extremely important for the real economy, an injection of liquidity into the real economy to support small and medium-sized enterprises is exactly what we need, especially at a time when we will be facing setbacks as a result of the coronavirus. I think this is a time to really support the real economy. So in that sense, this initiative couldn't be more timely. So thank you again for being here, and thank you again also for the support you're providing us in dealing with the migration crisis, which is a European problem. Greece is at the forefront of this crisis, and beyond what we are obviously obliged, and we're doing, I think, very successfully, which is to protect our borders, we also need to have necessary funding to provide the support that is required to alleviate pressures on our islands, but also on the mainland in dealing with this crisis, which also obviously has a humanitarian aspect. So thank you again very much for being with us.
Prime Minister, it's a great honor and a privilege to see you again, and thank you for taking the time to greet me and the delegation from the European Investment Bank and European Investment Fund. Minister, good to see you again. Yanis, Minister, our colleague from Luxembourg, who's obviously now dedicated to using his skills and experience built up in the EIB group to supporting investment levels in Greece. Colleagues and ladies and gentlemen of the press, it's a great pleasure to be here. It's a real privilege, obviously, to be able to sign today this agreement for a new small business financing initiative. This is a 100 million mandate from the Greek government to the European Investment Fund, the subsidiary of the European Investment Group, whose mission is to improve financing conditions for SMEs, mainly through loan guarantees and through the provision of equity financing. And this 100 million mandate from the Greek Ministry of Development and Investment to the European Investment Fund is designed to unlock 500 million of new financing for companies, for SMEs across Greece over the coming years. And it will do this obviously through a guarantee mechanism by making it more attractive and more profitable, essentially, for Greek commercial banks to extend financing on attractive terms to Greek SMEs. With the signing of this mandate, obviously, we will expect then in the coming months to seek expressions of interest from the commercial banks to deploy this guaranteed mechanism and to deploy the financing. And obviously, they'll be competing to the extent of offering the most attractive possible terms on the basis of this guarantee to Greek SMEs. It's obviously designed to address what continues to be still quite a significant financing gap for SMEs in Greece. Obviously, the commercial banking system is improving significantly, but nonetheless, this gap remains and is a challenge for the economy in terms of bringing investment levels back to where they need to be in order to deliver on the government's ambitions for stronger economic growth. And this is particularly true, obviously, in the current environment and the current increased uncertainty that now pervades not just Greece, but the European and global economies generally. And if anything, it's likely that the financing challenge for SMEs will only get more difficult in the coming months and years as this uncertainty affects decision-making in the financial system. And that's why I think the timing of this is particularly important and particularly appropriate. The economic and social impact of the new initiative, we believe, will be strengthened by the combined financial expertise and technical experience of the local banks, obviously the Greek government and the mandator, the European Commission and the European Investment Bank Group. And it demonstrates our shared commitment to work together to enable the Greek private sector to flourish in the coming years. We're also, in the context of obviously the other major concern that Greece and Europe are dealing with, which is the migration crisis, obviously, on Europe's border with Turkey, on Greece's border with Turkey. We're delighted to also be able to announce two initiatives. Firstly, will be the immediate deployment in the coming weeks of 200 million of financing for infrastructures needed to cope with the increased number of migrants in those particular regions of Greece that face the most acute challenges. This is financing that's already approved for Greece, and essentially what we're doing is reprofiling it to priority infrastructures in the priority regions to cope with the increased pressures. This will be for infrastructures like housing, accommodation, water, health, and so on. But we are also going to discuss with our board of directors next week a significantly increased package and to increase our level of ambition in terms of supporting economic resilience in those countries that are on the front line of the migration crisis, obviously particularly Greece, but also Bulgaria and Cyprus. And next year, I intend to have a discussion with our board of directors in Luxembourg as to how we can significantly increase our level of ambition in this particular area to complement, obviously, what the European Commission has already announced. So I expect we'll be able to announce more measures in the coming weeks that will demonstrate the solidarity of the EIB as the EU bank with the challenges being faced by the Greek people at this particular time. So, Prime Minister, thank you very much.
Thank you. That the EIB recognizes that it needs to address these extraordinary challenges that we are facing. And currently, the Greek government is dealing with two crises simultaneously. Most European governments are dealing with one crisis, which has to do with the virus. We have to deal with two crises simultaneously. And it is very important to know that all the European institutions are supporting us in this effort. The leadership of the European Union was present in northern Greece, at the borders of Greece with Turkey, to demonstrate its solidarity in Greece's effort to protect our borders, which are also Europe's borders. And of course, it is extremely encouraging that you are recognizing the need to mobilize additional financial resources to help us cope with this extraordinary situation. So we'll be looking forward to engage with you, with the board, on innovative financing mechanisms as we move forward. But again, I would like to thank you for this particular initiative. And I'm sure the minister, who's also a business person, and every single business person in Greece who has tried and failed to get a loan from a Greek commercial bank simply because the guarantees that were requested were exorbitant, will recognize the value of what it is that we're doing today, and we'll see real difference in a few months once the commercial banks are actually on board. So again, thank you very much. Looking forward to sign the necessary agreement.